Hey, this is SGU, and welcome back to our Madden 18 franchise mode with the Detroit Lions. Week 1 gave us a victory over the Arizona Cardinals, as you see a big run by Ameer Abdullah, who was forced into action by an injury to starter Theo Riddick after the very first play of the season. We answered quite nicely, though, taking the lead back there before halftime on our way to a victory, but this victory was a very costly one. Not only did we lose Theo Riddick, but we lost Ameer Abdullah as well, and also Killebrew at the strong safety position. He's a depth player, not a starter. Still kind of hurts. Now, some of you said the developers said bump down the injuries, and I've done that to 10, but we have this problem now where our top two running backs are out for at least 3 weeks, five in the case of Theo Riddick. So I left you hanging at the last episode with the question to answer in the comments section: what should we do with the running back position? Should we just rely on our depth, or should we pursue somebody via trade or free agency? Now, this comment was kind of interesting because it ends up being pretty spot on to what I end up doing. Now, full disclosure, I actually made the move and solved our running back situation when I posted that week one video. I just held it out to see what you guys would suggest doing and see if anybody came close to what I actually pulled off. So I look starting at the top of the list. Tevin Coleman. I know they've got Devontae Freeman and paid him handsomely. So Tevin Coleman could be had, right? Let's try a third round pick and a tight end, maybe. Maybe that would work. They don't have very much interest in the tight end. Let's try it anyway. Let's see what we can do if we offer this up. And oh my goodness, they accepted the trade. Oh, wow. That works out perfect for me. I get an 86 overall running back. I get an upgrade due to our injuries, and it'll make one of our running backs tradable when they come back, if they're back before the trade deadline anyway. So holy smokes, I am more than pleased to give up a player at a depth position. He was fourth on our tight end depth chart, and a third round pick to get Tevin Coleman, who could be a difference maker. Okay. Now I think we're okay, feeling better going into week two against the New York Giants on Monday Night Football.
Thank you, Larry. Coming to you from just off the New Jersey Turnpike in East Rutherford, we are just about set for football on EA Sports from MetLife Stadium. This crowd a few minutes ago stirred into action at the sight of their men in blue emerging from the MetLife tunnels. We're set to go as the Giants get ready to match up with the Detroit Lions.
Can I just say at this point, say what you want about Madden 18 gameplay. Might be up your alley. You might say same old, same old. I see all the gamut of comments in my gameplay videos and stuff, but the opening scenes, the fireworks, all that stuff looks amazing. Visually, Madden 18 looks really nice this year. So Tevin Coleman's very first carry as a Lion goes for 5 yards, and he didn't get injured, so already an improvement. On second and five, you got the single back here. You got Stafford stepping into one over the middle and finding his tight end, Eric Ebron. Had a big day in game one in the victory over the Cardinals. Starting off hot here as well. Second and eight, he finds his other tight end. Fells makes the catch, and they are down inside the 30 of the Giants, just like that, moving the football. We like the early momentum that our offense is providing on the first drive. First and 10 now from the 27. Handoff to Tevin Coleman. He's going to fight for good first down yardage, and he'll set us up eventually now third and three. As Stafford looking to connect. Oh, he threads the needle in the end zone. It's caught by Golden Tate, and it's a touchdown. First touchdown catch of the year for Golden Tate. Second thrown by Matthew Stafford on the young season. And the Lions have the early lead, or do they? We're going to have a booth review. Want to make sure Golden Tate got the feet in bounds. Looked like one and two if you count that first one. Yeah, looks like it's planted down. Second one inbounds. We should be good. Looks like he has possession. And they do indeed uphold the call. So it's 7-0. And here comes Eli Manning. Rough week one for him in a loss. Two touchdowns, but four interceptions sunk the Giants in week one. And that is why they are with this 0-1 record. But now at home and looking to win their first football game of the year. Got third and six, but no problem right there for Shane Vereen to pick up the first down. Later in the drive, the Giants again on third and long. They'll go play action this time, and Eli is going to be taken down. Fumble. His own offensive lineman finally falls on the football, but it's going to be fourth and 20 after the sack. So the Giants can do nothing on their first drive. Let's check this again. Shane Vereen tries to go up against Haloti Ngata here with the blocking, but he's right in Eli's face, and he just gets pushed right back into him. So that is not successful whatsoever. Look at it, just coming through like a bowling ball, knocking pins down, including Eli Manning, who loses the football. But at least they get to punt here. So third and one, and here is Tevin Coleman. Look at him spin, staying on his feet. I like what we're seeing so far. Six carries, 34 yards in his first action as a Detroit Lion, coming over in the trade. First and 10 now. Stafford going to throw over the middle, and again it's Fells. And again he's wide open. The running game setting that up. First quarter at this point has been all the visitors, the Lions, having their way. Third and 10, though, in the blitz, and Eli Apple is going to get to the quarterback. So maybe I spoke too soon. As far as that momentum goes, you got Matt Prater with a big leg. He holds the NFL record, trying from 57 this time. It's just short. So we do not get any more points tacked on here, and we give them pretty good field position about midfield, second and 7. You got play action, and Eli goes down. Yeah, play action's not going to work when we're sending safety blitz, trying to put the pressure on Eli before he can pick us apart, thrown to Odell Beckham Jr. and company. Third and 12 now, and Eli goes down again. He fumbles the football, and this one we've got. I don't know why they did not let Haloti Ngata run with that, but a bigger problem for the Giants than losing the football is they may have lost their starting quarterback. Oh boy, Eli Manning in some considerable pain right there. We know all about the injuries from week one, but there's Eli sitting without his helmet on the trainer's table and not looking like he's going to return anytime soon. The backup here is Geno Smith, if you're wondering. But right now it's the Lions offense on the field, and they have a short field to go to try to make this a 14-0 game. You've got Tevin Coleman fighting for another first down. Going up two scores would be huge here, considering you don't know that Eli Manning would be coming back in this game or not. Tevin Coleman rips one right up the middle, and he will score. Nice long gain there, and pay dirt. Wow, Tevin Coleman paying immediate dividends, bringing him in on the trade. I'm really liking our move here, and I'm liking our balance now with the run game and the pass game as Tevin Coleman finds a huge hole right up the middle. It's not as if Theo Riddick and or Ameer Abdullah are bad running backs, not at all. But there seems to be a little extra oomph going on here with Tevin Coleman running the ball. And Eli Manning, there it is, a shoulder tear. He is definitely not coming back to this ballgame. And now you got to rely on Geno Smith. Third and long, they're going to set up a screen to Shane Vereen, but he gets tripped up before he can get the first down. It will be a punting situation for the Giants, who are in a bit of trouble right now. You see Tevin Coleman already over 60 yards running and the touchdown. Will we lean on him again on this drive? Well, we'll try off the left tackle. And oh my goodness, he just trucked somebody right there. That's a big time run. See what I mean? He's putting a little power into that as well. And he is just punishing defenders right now. 78 yards on 10 carries. Third and 6. Here's Stafford. Going to throw to Matt Asiata, checking in as the third down back. He's going to get the first down. Injury timeout. Okay, it's a Giants injury. We dodge a bullet right there. We don't need another running back going down. Second and 8 now, 3:17 to play before the half. Here comes across the field Marvin Jones, and he's got a first down. Looking to add onto this lead before halftime. We got about 3 minutes or so, and we're moving down to the 30 of the Giants. First and 10, throwing over the middle again. It's a first down, down to the 11-yard line, and it's Eric Ebron. Tight ends making a impact in this first half. As you see, Coach Caldwell liking what he's seeing. He says, let's keep going. Keep this momentum going. First and 10, right up the middle. He's going to have it to the 5, maybe inside the 5. Second and 4. Coleman set us up here now, but trying to, he should have stayed in the pocket there, Stafford. That didn't work out very well. Wanted to actually just throw that ball away, but didn't have the time eventually to do it. Third and 15, and just too much time. Stafford's going to go down. Oh, please tell me that's not Stafford that's injured. Okay. Whew. I get nervous every time now after week one. The kick by Prater up and good, and we extend the lead to 17-0 with under a minute to play before half. Now Geno Smith hitting the field once again. Whoa, look at Eli. Yeah, no, Eli, your shoulder is torn. Get off the field. Okay, that was a little weird that he's in that cutscene, but no, Eli Manning not playing. Somebody went and got him back off the field quickly before he does more damage to that shoulder. Anyway, Geno connects there, and they're moving into Lions territory. Another first down, 22 seconds, and this time is ticking away. They have first and 10, and a handoff to Shane Vereen. I guess they are setting up for a field goal here. Timeout with 5 seconds left. And will they finally get their first points of the day? Up and good. So they get 3 points just before halftime. Maybe that'll spark something for them in the second half as they come on out here. Down 14 and with their backup quarterback. But let's see what happens for them. They will get the ball first after getting that field goal. And they're trying to go out wide. Shane Vereen can't get past the initial contact and he's going to lose 3 yards. This ends up being 3rd and 12 in play action. Geno Smith throwing, and he's throwing to the wrong team. Lions pick it off, coming back the other way. Inside the 20 to the 15. Mark him down at the 13. Big turnover right there. And the Boo Birds starting to be heard at MetLife Stadium as Wilson makes the interception and darn near takes this back for a pick six. Let's watch it again. Ill-advised throw, trying to make something happen. Pressing right there is Geno Smith. And, well, it's not looking good. It's at the start of the second half for the Giants. As you see, nice coverage right there. Just lurking back there and making the pick. So, can we make them pay for this and put more points on the board? Let's find out. 2nd and 7. Stafford going to throw over the middle. That's his tight end coming out of the backfield. That's Ebron making the catch for 1st and goal. Now, on 2nd and goal, Stafford going to roll to the right, and this time wide open for him to just run into the end zone. Too easy right there. Another score for the Lions, and things are falling apart for the Giants quickly here in the third quarter, now 24-3. Matthew Stafford scrambles for his first running touchdown of the season. He's always good for a few of those a year, especially when he meets such little resistance as he did on this play. Everyone involved in coverage and no chance to check the quarterback. So here comes Geno Smith again. Actually doing all right besides the pick, 5 of 7 for 50 yards, but they have a big uphill battle now, down 24-3, play action, and he has time to throw this time, which is a big improvement, and he hits Brandon Marshall on the big gainer, going to be down to the 22-yard line of the Lions. They're going to have to get down here and get touchdowns, though, not field goals. That's got to be their goal. 2nd and 4, he got the fullback in. Shane Vereen following for a 1st down and goal, down to the 4-yard line. Okay, now they got some momentum going. Can they punch it in and make this a ball game here late in the third quarter? Geno Smith, he's not going to throw yet. I actually missed him on the sack, came back around, and was still able to get him. Boy, Geno, you got to be more mobile than that. Get the ball out of there. And instead, it's 4th down, and they're kicking another field goal. They don't have time for this. It's 24-6. They get more points. But, yeah, not what they needed in the form of touchdowns. 3rd and 4 for the Lions, trying to screen pass to Asiata. Nope, Giants are on that, and they're going to make us punt for, I believe, the first time in the game. You feel a little more urgency out of this Giants squad. They don't want to go down 0-2, although that is looking the direction they are going. Here's Shane Vereen making a catch and getting a 1st down close to midfield at the 46. 2nd and 10, Geno Smith out of the shotgun. He is going to throw to the sideline, somehow completes that, and then getting away is the tight end, Ingram, and he is going to be all the way down to the 11-yard line. Kind of a busted play there when we try to make a play on the football, and instead it's completed and he gets more yardage after the catch. 3rd and 1, we bowl in there and make a stop. Big loss of 3-4 yards, and now on 4th and 5, they're going for it, but they're going to get it. Odell Beckham has been quiet all day, but he finds the end zone on this pass. And, well, if they go for 2, they could make it a 10-point game. Only 5 minutes and change remaining, though, so they got to hurry up whatever they're going to do. Surprisingly, here we'll watch the replay. As you see, a nice pass by Geno Smith after changing course a little bit there, and then he finds Odell Beckham Jr. flashing open. Surprisingly, they do not go for 2. They make it a 24-13 game. Stafford, not a lot of yards passing compared to week one, but he is very accurate, 11 of 13 in this game, and he hasn't had to throw a lot because of this guy, Tevin Coleman. Look at him just throwing off defenders. And by the way, that offensive line really going to work now on a worn down defensive front when it counts. First and 10, Tevin Coleman again, a big hole, and he's able to barrel forward for a first down. By the way, he's over 100 yards at 125 right now. Pitch to the right. Haven't seen a lot of pitches, but it's effective here. Spin move. Oh my. Nice run for another big first down. Killing more of this clock. We're getting close to the 2-minute warning. First and 10, Matt Asiata. Same result. O-line opening up a big hole for him as well. And you're close to first down. Although, third and 2. We need a conversion here. Going to the air. And there you go. That's pretty much ball game. Eric Ebron makes the catch at the 6-yard line. Timeouts need to be taken now by the Giants. Just a matter of hanging on to this, make them use all the timeouts. Or Tevin Coleman could barrel into the end zone. Well, he's close. He's down to the 1. Another timeout. Giants just hanging on for dear life here, trying to make a stop. But the pitch, a good block, sealing the outside. And Tevin Coleman has his second rushing touchdown of the day. Welcome to Detroit. Tevin Coleman, I think you'll fit in quite nicely as he rushes for over 100 yards and 2 scores in his Lions debut on the road here, salting away a victory against what's going to be now the 0-2 New York Giants. Tough start for them, especially since Eli Manning might miss multiple weeks now with that shoulder tear, and they're moving forward with Geno Smith, who eventually reluctantly decides to run here, gets good yardage, but you know they're running out of time right here. A minute 19 to play, first and 10, throw to the sideline. I thought maybe we'd knock that down, but no, he gets it out to Harris for the first down, and he's out of bounds. 1:14 to play, second and 10 now, play action, and the throw over the middle. Finds Ingram again. He will have the first down at the 16-yard line. Geno Smith running for his life at the 20-yard line. He's hauled down. It's going to be another sack. Ziggy Ansah's second of the game. 4th and 15, they got to go for it. And they got to convert the throw right at the first down line. They will give him the first down just barely. 2nd and goal now. 19 seconds to play. Geno Smith finds the end zone again. It's Ingram's first ever touchdown in the NFL. So a nice moment for the young man personally. However, it looks like it's going to come in a loss unless they can recover an onside kick and really do some damage here in just a few seconds, but at least they responded in the second half. Geno Smith could have been absolutely awful after that pickoff, but he recovered. He got a lot of, I guess, what you could call garbage passing yards in this game. He's going to outthrow Matthew Stafford in this game, mostly out of necessity. You see, the onside kick is fielded, and we are going to end up winning this thing by the score of 31-20. 2-0 are the Detroit Lions. They come in to MetLife Stadium here, and they do quite well. Eli Manning with the shoulder tear, somehow, some way, still in uniform there and looking frustrated, but he'll be even more frustrated if he's kept off the field long term. Here are your two quarterbacks. I think Eli officially never got a pass thrown because he doesn't show up in the stats before he was injured. Tevin Coleman, 25 carries, 168 yards, and 2 touchdowns. Beast. Welcome to the football club. We're glad to have you. And like I said, it'll make one of our other running backs expendable, which we can maybe build for draft picks or parts here to help strengthen maybe the defense. I don't know. Something moving forward. It gives us some flexibility. You see the passing or receiving numbers as well. So now I know some of you in the comments in episode 1 were talking about, hey, Stafford got that big extension in real life. You going to do it here too? Well, I can't see allowing him to walk. So we'll definitely work on giving him a new contract. Now, looking at the rest of our situation here, a lot of these won't open up till later weeks, but I have never seen such a long list of upcoming free agents in any of the franchise I've run. I mean, this is a ton. How are we going to sign all these? I mean, I guess that's the point. We're not going to be able to sign all these. We're going to have to make some tough decisions here, I would imagine. And some of these lower rated guys will probably not be that tough of a decision, but we've got a lot of players to tend to as we move forward in this franchise in our first year. And moving forward in our next game is going to be the 1-1 Atlanta Falcons coming to Ford Field. Tevin Coleman gets a shot at the club that just traded him away. Should be some great storylines in this one as we come back for week 3. We will see you guys then.